Hey there, Vanessa DiBerlay here. I wanted to come today and help explain domain, subdomain, autoresponder, SMTP. It is really confusing if you're not sure what you're doing. So I'm teaching beginning affiliate marketing, and this is something for me that it took some time to really understand what was going on. Typically, when you are doing affiliate marketing, you're using a website or a blog or a funnel to promote your affiliate marketing items. And every time you have a new website or a new funnel, you need to have a domain. I'm going to talk about funnels because that's what I use. I don't use a website. So let's scratch that as far as having a new website for every different affiliate marketing product. You're probably using different pages and things like that. And I'm not going to share that because I don't use it. But every time you create a new product, you have to create a new funnel that you're promoting. Okay. And I thought at first that I had to have a new domain every time. So I ended up buying like three domains before I realized I can create a subdomain. Now, I have a video that I shared below that I've already done before. How do you create that subdomain? But I want you to think about subdomains as here's an apartment building, and the whole apartment building is called domain, and every single one of the apartments are subdomains. Okay, if you think of it like that, then you can still work together, all live together in that one domain or that one apartment building, but everybody has their own little apartment. So each apartment is like each of your funnels, okay? So you have your whole business under your domain, and every time you go to create a funnel for maybe a new product or a new company or something like that, some people make very complicated funnels and they only use the one subdomain, but in the beginning, I think we tend to think more funnel product, like that. And that's okay. You are where you're at. But hopefully that helps you understand the difference between the subdomain and the domain. So you can only have to pay for one domain, and it might be your name. I have VanessaDeBerlay.com. I have a couple others, but that one is in my name. A lot of people do that. And then when I go to create a new funnel, I put a subdomain, which means in front of it might say, let's say if there's a book.com secrets, I'll put DCS slash VanessaDeBerlay.com. And that's my subdomain. That's what I use in that funnel where I'm promoting that product. Does that make sense? I hope that does. For me, that made sense. Okay, now, why am I putting SMTPs and autoresponders? Because I use a program called Actionetics. It's my autoresponder, and I use it in ClickFunnels. And when I went in there and set up my funnel, I was told I had to have an SMTP to deliver my mail. Now, before that, I was using a program called AWeber, and AWeber didn't make me have an SMTP. Okay, this is what I've learned. Okay, Actionetics is in ClickFunnels, and I think ActiveCampaign does the same thing with certain companies. That if you integrate ActiveCampaign, they might say, okay, you can use our autoresponder, but you have to go find your own SMTP. And that was really confusing to me. Some autoresponders, like MailChimp, AWeber, I'm just naming a few, different parts of ActiveCampaign, when you enroll with them, they already have the SMTP there for you. It's already there and you don't have to do anything. But if you use something like Actionetics, that platform only has your mail on it, but it doesn't have anybody to deliver it. And that's what the SMTP is. So this is what makes sense to me. All of these little houses are my funnels with their subdomains. My domain is up here. Welcome to the neighborhood. Big domain, that's my business. Every little house is my funnel, right? They're under my domain. And my mail, these M, the all my mail is getting delivered by coming from my autoresponder, which is Actionetics or ActiveCampaign, but I have to have somebody deliver it for me. And that's what the mailman is down here, the little truck. That's the SMTP. And I actually use SendGrid to do it. If you are dealing with an autoresponder where you have to have your own SMTP, that's the best way I can explain it. If you're already using something and they've never said anything about going and getting another product, you probably just want to ignore all this. AWeber doesn't. When I used AWeber, everything was done for me. And that's why I got confused when I went to Actionetics. It was like, wait a minute. So this is the best way I can explain it. The SMTP SendGrid is my mailman, right? And my mailman is delivering my mail, all of my emails for me that I wrote in Actionetics. And they're all going to my funnels that are my subdomains, and then my domain is up here. And that was the best way I can explain it. I hope that helped. If it confused you, then turn it off. Go find somebody else's, right? But that it just took me a while, and that was I needed a picture. Hopefully you were in the same boat and you got it too. I have below a link to Actionetics if that is a autoresponder that you would like to use. You can go ahead and click that link, and there's actually in that platform a 14-day free trial, and that's the one I gave you. I love the free trials because especially when you're new, you feel like you're constantly going to all these platforms and you're not sure what they do, and you're putting money out and you want to make sure you're making wise decisions. It's not like we don't want to pay for things, but it's really hard to keep putting money out when you're not sure what you're getting. So there is a 14-day free trial. Go under the Actionetics and check it out. And if you decide you want a one-stop platform, it's all right there for you. That is what I love about this platform is I don't have to go and get six different tools and different softwares. It's all right there for me. And for me, that has been a big relief. So again, we're all different. Some people don't mind all that, but if you're looking for something like that and you want to check it out, 14-day free trial, just click the link. No commitment. All right. Check it out. And hopefully this helped. Give me your comments. If I confused you, I can come back and re-explain it. I promise. I'm not trying to confuse anyone. I was just trying to lay it out in a picture so that maybe that would help. All right. Until I see you again, have a great one.